Sexual energy is the magnetism that creates the pull back to oneness. So that's why the polarity is so important, is because it's like two puzzle pieces coming together to orient back to the whole. And this isn't necessarily even, like he was saying, sexual energy. And apart from that, sexual energy is inherent with life. It is the primal force that drives evolution and drives procreation, proliferation and expansion. So like, for example, in Chinese medicine, they'll ask you what your libido is like to gauge your health. Not saying that not feeling sexual doesn't, you know, that doesn't mean necessarily that you're unhealthy, but this sense of like, this sense of pulsating undercurrent of life. They talk about generating in the lower Dantian area, the area that we worked with yesterday, we poured red light into. This area interconnects all of us. And it's the driving force of humanity. So there's so much there. Meaning that I think the misunderstanding or the etymology behind the actual word sin, the ignorance behind sexuality, is that it is when you feel it arise in your body that it is to be acted out, when actually it's just a pulsating vibration that is coursing through your life and through your trajectory. So again, in Chinese medicine, they talk about the birth gateway and how when your mother and father came together, the imprint of your soul comes in. And at that time, all of the primal force is imprinted in your body. These are the codes that I'm talking about. They're the codes from all of your ancestors and beyond, like beyond what we can... So this encodement drives your being, your essence, what we would call your calling here. So it's a breathing, moving, pulsing essence in your life, and not necessarily to be only looked upon when someone is outside of you. If you close your eyes, you can feel if you're activating or activated this pulsating force inside of you. It's that life force, that primal life force energy. So there is a purity there because it is what, it's like the unconscious realm. And that's where the discrepancies can come in, is because it's so subtle. So anytime that there's that seeking outside of self, because it's the driving force of evolution, there can be distortion that comes into play. So it's good to get in touch with that primal force. It's good to get in touch with your own sexuality, with your own relationship to feeling infused with this force of life, and knowing what that drive, what that magnetism, where it's taking you. That's why, you know, again, the calling work is so important. That main point that, you know, what did you call it? You know, it's like the arrow that you're constantly driving. And then you can compare if a person or an environment or a decision is in alignment with that whole driving force.